Hello, everybody. Gage says it's empty. Let's go see what's in the fridge today. Hey guys, thanks for stopping by Grass Beer Reviews today. Today's beer comes from Community Beer Company. These guys are down in Texas. This was sent to me by Brandon C. He's down in Texas. He sends me a lot of beer from down there in Texas and the surrounding states that I cannot get here in Virginia. So I appreciate it, Brandon. Do appreciate the wonderful beer packages, beer mail package you send. This is their Oaked Mosaic IPA, and this is a fairly big beer. On the side of the bottle here, it says the alcohol is 8.6 on this. So this is an Imperial or a Double IPA, and it's got the IBUs listed right underneath there at 85. As far as a date, I am not seeing anything on the label. There may be something on the bottle that I do not see. I do not see any kind of dating on it. So these guys definitely need to do that. If they're going to produce an IPA or a double IPA, it needs to have that information on there, in my opinion, guys. Let me pull this off and see if it's underneath the tape that Brandon has put on there. No, I do not see it. Just a government warning is underneath the tape here. Anyway, we'll look at the bottle when I come back and see if there's any kind of dating on it. And that would probably be a great point, guys, if it doesn't have the date on it. They need to do that. I don't know how big the brewery is, but that's part of it. If you're going to produce an IPA or a double IPA, it needs to have a bottled on date. Not a used by, best by, enjoyed by, none of that horse shit. A bottled on date. So, we'll check it when I come back, because I can't tell you how old the beer is. I'm sure it's the freshest one that Brandon can get his hands on, but they need to do that. Commercial description on this one, well, I'll tell you right off the bat. Beer Advocate has this listed as 7.5. That's wrong. Untappd has it listed at 8.6. So the bottle here has 8.6. So Untappd has got the correct ABV on it. And they've got the IBUs listed too. But both of those are easy to find on here. So it's written right on the side of the label. Very easy to find. They need to do the date the same way. Put it right on the label, right underneath that. With Beer Advocate having it listed at 7.5%, they've probably done this beer multiple times. And this is what this one ended up being as far as the ABV on this one. Commercial description, and I'm reading this off the 7.5 that Beer Advocate's got. Let's see what, let's not use that. Let's go over here to Untappd since they have the correct ABV and IBUs. We'll read their commercial description. Barrel aged Mosaic IPA, and it's got a question mark. Not quite. Aging a hop focused beer in barrels will greatly diminish the hop aromas. I tell you guys that all the time. It is absolutely asinine to do a IPA or a double IPA and then put it in barrels for 2, 3, 6, 8, 12 months. The hops are going to fade completely out unless you dry hop it again after it comes out of the barrels. You're going to lose every bit of that hop aroma. So, in my humble opinion, I don't think you should barrel age an IPA or a double IPA. Just my opinion, though. Evidently, these guys agree with me. Says, will greatly diminish the hop aromas that we've toiled to create. Fortunately for us, we have the ability to add oak spirals, carefully milled helixes of toasted American oak to our aging tanks, and now a hop gun. This process infuses our beloved Mosaic IPA with delicious notes of oak, honey, vanilla, and coconut while preserving the beautiful hop profile. That's the way you could do it. Now, you could do bourbon barrel soaked oak spirals if you wanted to do it that way to get some hints of some bourbon in there. But to taking the beer after it's done and putting in barrels to let it age, the hops are going to just drop right off. Just like I put it in a bottle without knowing that, and you set it on the closet for a year before you decided to drink it. It's not going to taste anywhere as good as it did the first month it was in the bottle, up to 3 months. And then each month, even after the first month, it's going to diminish a little bit. And then once you get to the 6 month category, it's going to be a malt bomb, basically. It is. And some people like that. They don't like that big hop up in your face, forward West Coast or New England style. It's just super pungent and all that. Some people like to taste some maltiness in their IPAs and double IPAs. And if you're one of those, that's cool. I don't have a problem with that, but I'm not in that crowd. I want to get all of that hop taste and aroma. So, that's all we need to talk about. So let's stop talking and start pouring. Got plenty of openers, plenty of t-shirts. If you need one, give me a shout. All right, into the glass we go. And while I'm putting it in the glass, I'll tell you the cuisine is barbecue, cheese and pepper, Monterey, pepper jack, sharp blue cheddar, your stronger cheeses, gorgonzola and Limburger. The meat is game, grilled meat, and salmon. Last of our snicker, tulip, oversized wine glass. And not recommended for cellaring. It didn't pour hardly any head. It is a deep, rich amber. Not quite to the red characteristics, but it is a deep amber. Almost to the red. Not quite. Let's get a nose on it. Guys, I'm getting a big maltiness on the beer. Little hints of not really. It's more of a herbal, floral, earthy hop presence at this stage. And that could be because of the age of the beer or where they were going. I don't know yet. Like I said, we'll look at the bottle when I come back and see if we can find any dating at all on it. Smells more malty than hoppy right now, guys. And that's a shame. I'm not even getting the vanilla or the coconut or anything, any woodiness on the nose. So, I hope it's not an old beer. Cheers, everybody. Cheers, Brandon. A little bit of citrusy hops in the taste, but it is very subdued, guys. To me, it reminds me more of an East Coast style than a West Coast or a New England style IPA. This hint more maltiness than those styles would have. Not bad. It's not a malt bomb yet, but to me, it tastes like it's well on its way. It does have a very nice sweetness to it. The good thing about this, the alcohol is very well hidden for it, 8.6%. IBUs are 85. I'm getting a little bit of that bitterness on the back end, but it's not overpowering. Seems to be a balanced beer as far as the sweetness and the bitterness, but it is a little lackluster on the hop presence and taste. So, well, let's run out of the fridge and let it warm up. And like I said, I'll look at that bottle when I come back and see if we can find any kind of dating. I'll be right back. All right, guys, I'm back. Been sitting on it for about 20, 30 minutes now. I looked at the bottle when I got back. There's absolutely no dating on it whatsoever. And with that being said, we have no idea how old the beer is. If they were going for this particular taste and aroma, good. Is it something that I'm seeking after on an IPA or a double IPA? No. Would I buy this beer? No. Not because of the taste, because it lacks the date. I want to know how fresh my IPAs or double IPAs are. Without them doing that, I would pick it up and look, no date, and then I would set it back up on the shelf. I still appreciate Brandon spending his hard-earned money on it and sending it to me to review, but it's a little maltier than the IPAs and the double IPAs that I like and I want to drink. And without that date, we have no idea. So, and they do that intentionally because it gives it a longer shelf life. But if I bought one or six of this, would I buy it again? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. The beer is not bad, but it's not got the hop aroma that I'm seeking after, especially in something they're calling Oaked Mosaic IPA. Mosaic is an extremely floral, upfront, in-your-face type of hop. And I don't know what the amount is that they use to brew it and all that. It doesn't say anything about dry hopping or anything like that, but it's just not what I'm seeking after when I look for an IPA or a double IPA, guys. That's just me, though. Final chug. More malty than hoppy. Now that it's warmed up a little bit, I am getting a little bit of woodiness in there, but I am not getting any vanilla or any coconut or anything like that in there. My humble opinion, I think this beer is at least 3 months old, if not older. I'm just guessing there, though. We have no date. All right. To me, guys, I would give this beer a B. 85 is where I would put it. Over to Beer Advocate. They say it's 90. Evidently, those guys got a fresher one than I did, or they like this style with more maltiness and hops. Over to Untappd. Untappd has it at 4.08, which is in their A category. So, same reasoning. Evidently, they've got a fresher bottle than I have, or they like a more malty beer than hop forward. I like the hop forward part of it myself. It's just me, though. If you don't like that, you may love this. It may be something that you don't like, that super up-in-your-face, pungent hop aroma. So, with that being said, that's where I'm going to put it. That's where we're going to leave it. So, if you've had this from Community Beer, this is their Oaked Mosaic IPA. Let me know what you think. I was not super impressed with this. It is still a tasty beer, but it's not to where I'm looking. Not something that I look for. I want more hops and the aroma and on the taste. And without the date, we're in limbo. So, if you have, let me know what you think, guys. And until we meet again, let's go see what's in the fridge.